Welcome in IndySportsCenters.com. We get you ready for the month of May and the 101st running of the Indianapolis 500. And no better guy to talk to about that than last year's pole sitter, James Hinchcliffe. James, thanks for your time.
Of course, anytime.
Let's talk about the month of May. The last couple of years, you've got the warm-up with the Grand Prix. You've had some up-and-down success in that, but the momentum that you can build, parlay that in the qualifying weekend like you did last year into the race, how important is it to be on track pretty much the entire month now?
It's great. I mean, for a long time, especially when my career started in IndyCar, we still referred to it as the month of May, but realistically, it was kind of the 2 weeks of May. You know, the schedule, the practice schedule had come back quite some years ago now, and now we can say the month of May again. You know, we were thrilled when they added the GP. I think it's been a great event. I think it's been really well received by the fans, by the drivers, and it does. It gives us an extra week at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, which is never a bad thing.
You mentioned the fans. Obviously, the 100th running sells out. This year, the ticket sales are going great. They're close to another almost sellout. I just talk about the fans and how much that means to come back in May and see them out there.
You know, for us, that's what it's all about. You know, as much as you like to go to bed at night thinking that this whole circus happens, or the 22 of us on a normal weekend, or the 33 of us during May get to go drive race cars, it's got nothing to do with us.
Yeah.
You know, it's all about the people that come to the track, that watch on TV at home. And, you know, for me, I was that kid with the Sharpie and the hero card for years before I ever had a steering wheel in my hands. And it means a lot to me to be able to do that, to give back, to interact with them, you know, whether it's in person, on social media, whatever it is. It's just such a big part of our sport.
Who are some guys for you growing up? Obviously, Greg Moore comes to mind that you were out there following, that, you know, were heroes to you growing up.
Well, you know, the Canadians for sure. Greg Moore obviously was my number one, but then Jacques Villeneuve, Paul Tracy, you know, Carpentier and Tagliani when they sort of came in. I was a big Dario Franchitti fan, don't tell him. You know, going back further, I liked Michael Andretti. I mean, he won the race in Toronto 7 times.
Yeah.
So I saw Michael win a lot as a kid. So, you know, it was hard to not like him. There was a bunch of guys, man. It was such a fun time in the sport.
James Hinchcliffe, driver of the number 5 Aero Electronics for Sam Schmidt, Peterson Motorsports. Thanks for tuning in.